In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And the Lord be with you. And brothers and sisters, so nice to be with you here together this morning, and also those online. Let's turn to the Lord and ask God to prepare ourselves for this Holy Mass as Jesus asked us to celebrate together as we do at the Last Supper. Let's ask God for pardon and peace to prepare us for this gift of the Mass from the Lord himself. And Lord Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you come to us in word and in sacrament. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life. Today we have a relatively new feast day. Augustine Zhao and companions for 122 Chinese martyrs. We humbly beseech the mercy of your majesty, Almighty and merciful God, that as you poured the knowledge of your only begotten Son into the hearts of the peoples by the preaching of the blessed martyrs, Augustine, Zhao, and companions, so that through their intercession we may be made steadfast in the faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, when Israel was a child, I loved him. Out of Egypt, I called my son. The more I called them, the farther they went from me, sacrificing to the Baals and burning incense to idols. Yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk, who took them in my arms. I drew them with human cords, with bands of love. I fostered them like one who raises an infant to his cheeks. Yet though I stooped to feed my child, they did not know that I was their healer. My heart is overwhelmed. My pity is stirred. I will not give vent to my blazing anger. I will not destroy Ephraim again, for I am God and not man, the Holy One present among you. I will not let the flames consume you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us see your face, Lord, and we shall be saved.
Let us see your face, Lord, and we shall be saved.
O Shepherd of Israel, hearken. From your throne upon the cherubim, shine forth. Rouse your power. Let us see your face, Lord, and we shall be saved. Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted, the Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. Let us see your face, Lord, and we shall be saved.
And my brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, as you go, make this proclamation. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, drive out demons. Without cost you have received, without cost you are to give. Do not take gold or silver or copper for your belts, no sack for the journey, or a second tunic, or sandals, or walking stick. The laborer deserves his keep. Whatever town or village you enter, look for a worthy person in it, and stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, wish it peace. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. If not, let your peace return to you. Whoever will not receive you or listen to your words, go outside that house or town and shake the dust from your feet. Amen, I say to you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town. The Gospel of the Lord. Well, today we have 122 Chinese martyrs, not all from the same time. They date from 1639 all the way up to 1930. 33 of them are non-Chinese, many with a group called the Paris Mission Bureau that sent missionaries over to China over a number of years. The rest are Chinese, of Chinese descent. Augustine Zhao was someone in 1815, was a martyr. He was baptized, and very quickly after, I guess he was doing his seminary studies while he was doing his baptism studies. Who knows the situation, but he was ordained several days after he was baptized, and not long after that became a martyr. But just whenever we're confronted with the martyrs, I think it really brings to the fore that notion of giving yourself totally to Christ, which to me was never something that was very attractive. I remember when I felt a call to the priesthood, God really, pushed me along on that. I ran away from it for a long time. But I remember, and I don't know if this is funny or sad, I remember literally saying to God, I said yes to the priesthood, I am not going to listen if you ask me to be a missionary. Like, I was close to my family, and I was like, I'm not going to go. Because I had been very open in my prayer, whatever your will is, Lord. And then I was like, oh no, I got myself in this much trouble. I just always think about those people. I have great respect for somebody who would say, I'm going to go to another continent and live my whole life serving people. And just I find that overwhelming. So let's give thanks that there's people who have that love of the Lord and that ability to say yes. I'm not saying I don't serve the Lord. There is a value to each one of us. But I look back on that and I think to myself, these are great examples, people that left everything behind in order to serve the Lord and then gave everything, faced up often. And you would imagine in many situations they knew all these 122 people. They all became saints, by the way, in the year 2000. But you would imagine in most of the cases they knew they were in dangerous territory during, whether it was 1639 or 1930. They knew that certain actions would get them in trouble. And over, century after century, they did it anyway. So let's remember their example today. Whatever troubles we're going through, and we all have troubles, don't we? Let's remember the great faith of the martyrs, the great faith of those who give everything to the Lord. May it inspire us to handle our own challenges today with faith. Brothers and sisters, let us stand and offer our prayers.
For all the members of the church, may the Lord bless us with an abundance of divine goodness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For law enforcement officers and all first responders, may they operate under the benevolent protection of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those riddled by anxiety, may the peace of the Lord give them solace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the young people in our community, may God stir in their hearts a deep love and reverence for Him. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, may perpetual light shine upon them and may they rest in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those special intentions we hold in our heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we ask all these prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. And pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May
you accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all the Church.
As we venerate the passion of your martyrs, Augustine, Zhao, and companions, grant that through this sacrifice, O Lord, we may proclaim worthily the death of your only begotten Son, who, not content with encouraging the martyrs by word, strengthened them likewise by example, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And my brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyrs poured out like Christ's to glorify your name and shows forth your marvelous works by which, in our weakness, you perfect your power, and on the feeble, bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You, therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the Word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us, when we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins. You brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom, for our sake, you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries, for when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body." Which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, when we eat this bread, drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, with Augustine, Zhao, and companions, and all the martyrs, and with all the saints, and with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. And we remember William Capps in a very special way at this Mass this morning, and also Stephen Zachary Sr. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. For it is through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And let us pray as Jesus taught us, Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And I know we're not shaking hands, but let's make sure. I think people need the sign of peace more than ever right now. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
And my brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, for those watching online, we'll now do a spiritual communion. Lord Jesus, I know that you are fully present in the most blessed sacrament of the Holy Mass. While I cannot receive you physically at this time, I ask you to enter into my heart for a spiritual communion. And let us pray. Having fed upon heavenly delights, we humbly ask you, O Lord, that by the example of Blessed Augustine, Zhao, and companions, we may bear in our hearts the marks of your Son's charity and suffering, and ever enjoy the fruit of perpetual peace through Christ our Lord. Hope you have a good day. Tonight, there's a rosary at 7 p.m. A little bit of Ron Brown's going to sing a little bit, just meditation songs, and not congregational singing, but a little bit of music, and then a 3-minute teaching on Mary and the saints. It's going to be live streamed, but also the doors will be open if you want to come down and pray the rosary here in the church during that. So that's 7 o'clock tonight. Live stream or here at the church, your choice. Hope you have a good day. Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. As Mass has ended, let us go in the peace of Christ. St. Michael.